Got on your back.
I give you a 20.
What?
I give you a 20. You gave me change back for a 10.
Well, I can count down my register, but you'll have to wait until the next customer.
I'm not gonna wait around.
Can I help you?
Yeah, your cashier refuses to give me my money back. I gave her a 20. She gave me change back for a 10.
I told you I can count down my register.
That's all we can do. If you can wait, we could take the next customer, and we'll be counting down anyways.
Thought you guys were open later.
Yeah, you two are the last ones. Get you out of here and get home.
Let's chitter chat. Let's hurry this up.
Have a good night.
I will.
Have a good night.
Thanks.
Jonathan, happy birthday.
Mom, something's wrong.
What's wrong, honey?
I think I need a doctor. I was bleeding and...
Here. Why don't you open your present?
No.
Yes, John. Now you have the freedom to do so much. We are the ones with the power. You will have so much power, you will feel it thrive in your body. You will gain so much from what you take. I know that you can steal. I can see it in you. Now you just steal life. It's not that hard. I was like you once. I had to grow up until the change. You just have to acknowledge it. I was just like you once. Just a very long time ago.
Hello and welcome to the audio commentary. This is with the writer-director, Jason Davis, and I hope you enjoyed the film. Now we're going... Now, these opening credits that are coming up here, these are done simply... I added this on Final Cut Pro, and this was done through the text generator on it. I basically did a little bit of a warping effect just so it wasn't as boring as it could have been. These pictures that are coming up, and this is the first one here of baby Zach. This wasn't the original beginning that I wanted. The original scripted beginning was him at a, not really a basketball game, an urban basketball court watching a game, and just it was to show him being an outsider. That, we tried shooting it twice, had major problems, a blizzard in April, long story. So we ended up going to, then we tried to do something of maybe just having him being a graffiti artist, doing some graffiti. Well, there became some legal issues with that, so, as well as we didn't get have time to send that out. So we just, pretty much without nothing until, I thought of, asking Zach and borrowing some pictures from him, and then just scanning them in and using that. I think it actually turned out pretty good. It's like a progression of his life. And since it's about him growing up and, you know, instead of turning into a man, he becomes this monster instead. So, which is, you know, what corporate America is. Now, this is inside Office Depot where we shot most of the film. There's me and I had to use him. He was a PA on the film. My actor didn't show up. But this is Office Depot, and the one restriction I had shooting here was that I couldn't have any Office Depot product in the shot. So anything with the Office Depot logo, nothing. So we had to constantly be taking down and watching for anything Office Depot that might pop up. Here he's going in to take a piss. And this, I basically just, I thought it'd be kind of funny to have him, you know, going to the bathroom. I just had this feeling that such a vulnerable time for any person is when they're going to the, you know, bathroom. They're just hanging their private parts out there. And it's just a very vulnerable time for something to happen. So I wanted that sense to be there. This was, all this makeup effects here was done by Matthew Stratton, an amazing makeup artist from Rockford, Illinois. I really appreciate how he helped me out with this. This is, and this transition right there, that was done Final Cut Pro and editing. Got a little bit on my website explaining kind of how to do that. So if you're interested, just visit my website and you'll be able to find that out. But then there he falls, and then we go into this next part here. Now the whole point of this part here was, I was really trying to show Office Depot closing down.
What?
As you can tell, this was probably a very hard scene to shoot because I had to take everything Office Depot out from behind and tear it all down, and we only had 3 hours to shoot it. We had to open it up.
Can I help you?
We had to shoot it before they opened one morning. Then there's also the fact that I had all these actors in here, and working for the first time with this group of actors, it was quite a new experience for me. We got plenty of coverage. I was so glad for that. And I was so glad we were shooting on digital right here, because we didn't have to light any of this. We just used natural lighting. And then in editing, I toned down the reds.
Have a good night.
Because the reds were popping way
up.
What else can I say about this thing? In the fact that they were all great actors.
Have a good night.
It was originally meant
Thanks.
To be a smaller scene. And then just when I had the auditions for it, all these great actors came in. And I just expanded the scene so I could use them all. I mean, just four out of the four best actors out of the audition. Now here, this was originally shot without zooming in, but we zoomed in post because when he did the two separate shots to show the fading out of the blood, the hand actually, his hand moved. So I had to zoom in past the hand so that we could do it, the fade without to be in a big noticeable change. Then this is all supposed to be just him slowly waking up. And when I originally meant to shoot it and edit it, it wasn't supposed to be this, you know, fade in, fade out. But there's just so much of a jump cut right here between this last two shots that I had ended up having to fade in, fade out. And I ended up loving how it slowed down the pacing. I didn't like how it was paced so fast originally. I wanted to slow it down. Here, this whole hallway scene right here that's coming up, I ended up originally cutting this out because I hated how it looked. But then I saw it again after we shot it, and I did fall in love with it. But at first, I got so mad at me and my DP, and just because I thought it was terrible, how it was lit. I'm so glad that I did just blow it out. Here's the scene. Once again, I'm playing the bum, and there's me again. He's a royal lump on that floor. This was just filmed actually outside the back of my apartment. It was freezing cold. We just really quickly shot it. We didn't get as many shots as I wanted to, but I tried to make it work. Now we're inside the apartment. I actually got my apartment building to let me shoot in an empty apartment, and we just built the set in there. Why I didn't just go to a soundstage and build it?
Happy birthday.
When I look at it now, I really don't know. Truthfully, I love how it turned out though, so.
Mom.
I wouldn't change anything.
Something's wrong. Just,
what's wrong, honey?
I really love the lighting.
I think I need a doctor. I was bleeding.
We really wanted it to be blacked out. We just was trying to.
Why don't you open your
this very
present?
High contrast. And this gift, actually, we got the box, and this is not actual ice inside here. This is actually just this special effects ice that my associate producer, Luis Dolarski, was able to find and order for me. And then that is, while fake blood is usually corn syrup, the PA, the idiot that he was, actually went and got,
you're one of us.
PAs. They're never worth anything.
No.
He went and got, what was it? Pancake syrup.
Yes, John.
And it actually turned out to be better than corn syrup.
You have the freedom.
I'm surprised
to do
more people don't use it.
We are the ones.
Lori Myers, she's an amazing actress.
You will have so much power.
She's so
feel it thrive.
Funny off screen and just so great
you
on screen.
You will gain so much.
I hope
what
I can
you
find
take.
You know room for in a few other my films coming up because I just was blown away by her in auditions.
I know she's that great. You can steal. I can
my
see
two main actors,
you.
Zach and Lloyd, they're just both fantastic.
Now you just
I can't
steal
say enough
life.
Good things about it.
It's not that hard.
This is basically
like
supposed to be where
to
he is starting to accept
change.
What he is
you just
becoming.
Have to acknowledge it.
And I just wanted
just
to go in and, you know, slowly move
just
through it,
a very
do a bunch of close-ups and have it. So he's just starting to really feel the fangs, and it's really dawning on him what he's becoming. And then with the eyes, I wanted to creep us out, the audience, while also kind of showing his acceptance. And that right there is Transformation Mirrors. I hope you enjoyed it. I really enjoyed making it. And once again, this is the writer-director, Jason Davis.